For 160 years, Battersea has been offering love and care to dogs and cats in need. This is the story of two recent arrivals, Mildred and Hector.
Hector got brought into us in a cardboard box today by a very caring member of the public, opened the box and was quite shocked to see a kitten missing half a tail and half a leg. I am concerned. It's a lot for a little kitten to go through. We are here because we love the animals. We see them come in all states. We get very clearly loved, cared for animals, but also the animals that are malnourished, covered in fleas, skinny, you name it, we've probably seen it. And it's heartbreaking sometimes what we have to deal with.
Mildred the pug has also been picked up off the street. She is suffering from malnutrition and a severe skin condition.
It just makes you feel just devastated inside.
Mildred is only 4 years old.
Knowing that she's going to be with our clinic team soon makes me feel so much better and gives me the reassurance that I need. She is a sweet girl and I just want her to get better.
So we've just collected Mildred from intake and we need to feed her up and ensure that she's sort of gaining weight while she's here with us, and then we can start her on treatment and try and get her as comfortable as possible.
Mildred is really lovely. She is so open as well and loving, even though, you know, she must be in so much pain. And it makes you think, how can you be like that if you've gone through what she has? But she is.
Mildred will need surgery from our expert clinic team. But first, she's put on a regime of regular baths to soothe her skin. Hector has also arrived in clinic.
I feel like we owe Hector a better future than what his life experience has been so far. My main concern is that he's missing this back right leg. With the stump the way it is, we know that he's caused injuries to it already. So the chances are that that's going to be something that's going to happen again. So for him, we're planning to do an amputation to shorten the stump so that it's not going to be at such a high risk of rubbing and causing trauma. Amputations do always carry risk, but we feel like it's something that's important for him that's really going to improve his quality of life. He's got some way to go before he's going to be ready to go home, unfortunately.
Because she's from a flat-faced breed, Mildred is having airway surgery to improve her breathing.
It is a complex surgery involving an operation at the back of the throat. The dog's life is on the table and it's really important that we do work together closely.
We work together relatively often and it's really good to have that teamwork, especially with these sort of more complex surgeries.
After the operation, Mildred is coming round from her anaesthetic.
She's a little bit worked up at the moment, which is understandable. It's my priority to stay with her until she's 100% okay and feeling as calm as possible.
Hector must wait to grow bigger before he can have his surgery. In the meantime, he has been fostered by a staff member.
Every kitten's a bit different from my experience in fostering. Sometimes they're a bit shy, sometimes they're a bit more confident. And Hector, hello. He loves older people, so he follows everyone around. I can't do anything in peace at home. He's a very special little boy. I think Battersea's really changed Hector's life, and I feel very privileged to be able to take him on foster and just see him blossom and grow up into the lovely young man that he is. And I think in the future for him, hopefully we'll find him a devoted home that loves him as much as I do.
What are you doing, Mrs? What are you doing?
Mildred is also on the mend.
Since Mildred's been at Battersea, her condition has improved dramatically. Not even just with her skin, it's improved so much, but just in herself. She's a little soldier.
The kennels team are providing her with round-the-clock care.
It's just hard knowing that this little helpless thing has been through so much in her life. I just want to give her that reassurance, just to say that, you know, life isn't that bad and there is good people out there and there will be people that will want to love you and want to care for you. My hopes for Mildred would be for her to get her forever home. It'd just be a nice ending to her story.
Battersea will always be here for every dog and cat, wherever they are, for as long as they need us.